Don't hesitate to put a lot in your neck behind your love. A little secret spot that the French woman has is you're going to put a bit of perfume behind your knees. Never ever smell coffee bean in the middle of an evaluation time. It will block your nose. So your wrist, you spray a good dose on each wrist, and your pulse points are quite intense in your neck and behind your lobe. So don't hesitate to put a lot in your neck behind your lobe. And then I recommend to have a big spray all around you on your hair, so when you move your head, people will smell you. And for the guy, you can put a lot on your chest like that. After you shave yourself, you put in your neck and on your chest. You feel really masculine, fresh and confident. For the summer, when you put a beautiful dress or skirt, a little secret spot that the French woman has is you're going to put a bit of perfume behind your knees here. So when you're going to walk, you're going to create a beautiful trail, a beautiful sillage, and guys will be, what is happening here? It smells so good. Yes, you can put perfume on your hair. It's just alcohol is going to dry a bit your hair, like it dry your skin. But hair is a very good substrate to keep the fragrance, the molecule. Like if you are very hairy, you will keep your perfume longer. Spray will give you a wide range, and you can put in a lot of part of your body on your hair. So my recommendation is to go for spray. And if you don't want to carry your big bottle, I mean, at Maison it's very convenient because we have this cute Nomad bottle. We have invented the dual crayon. So Roland is very trendy now, but it's more to touch up. You know, if you are in the office and you don't have time to come back home, so take your dual crayon. You can have your fresh scent for the morning, and you can have your amber for your sexy night. Dry skin is not appropriate, so if you have a very thin, dry skin, try to hydrate with a neutral cream. A lot of cream have perfume already, so if you want to put your beautiful perfume, your beautiful very own perfume from Maison, try to put a bit of cream, wait a bit, and it will absorb your perfume. It will keep it longer, so that's my recommendation.
So Johanna, I see a lot of people, after they spray their perfume, they rub it on their skin. Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Good question. If you rub gently, it's nice because you make the chemistry happening with your skin, and we saw it's so important to check how it's gonna happen on your skin. If you rub too hard, you're gonna create a friction, you're gonna heat the perfume and probably produce some enzyme that can modify the smell of the original perfume. So don't rub too hard, it's not good at all. Actually, there are two external parameters that will impact your scent, is the level of humidity and the level of the temperature. So if it's super hot and super humid, your perfume will evaporate very fast. If you can't smell it after half an hour, it's really bad quality. There are a lot of brands that tends to put a lot of top notes, which are cheap because they are the citrus, the fruity note, they are an expensive note. So how to check? You just take your clothes, and when you put your nose into your sweatshirt, or if the perfume is still there, it means it's a very good quality perfume. Coffee bean actually will not clean your nose, it will block your nose. It's so strong and so intense that it sends a message to your brain, and your brain just keeps the coffee smell and cannot smell anything else. So if you plan, you know, to smell a lot of things, like when you come to workshop at Maison, where you're gonna smell different things, just take a pause, go outside, change the air, smell your own skin. You can eat a bit of something very neutral, like some French bread, crackers, you know, but never ever smell coffee bean in the middle of an evaluation time. It will block your nose. So the two things a perfume is afraid of is the light, the sunlight, like us. Sunlight is not good for your skin, so it's not good for your perfume. And the oxygen. Mm. So when you start to use your perfume, you see a bit of oxygen entering, and it will provoke an oxidation with some molecule of the perfume. So as soon as you have start to decrease the level of your perfume, it's important to keep it in a place that is protected from the light and the heat. And the best place is your fridge or the wine cellar. So put it in the fridge, and especially if you go for a long time.